call it, that will take you to the article. And what we're going to do is we're going to go through this, and I'm going to tell you what I have to say, and you can add your amazing wisdom to it. You ready to go?
I'm ready.
Okay, make sure, and I'm speaking to all of you folks out there, make sure everyone in your circle of influence knows that the U.S. Patent Office steals patents from inventors. We've posted so much about this over the last year. They are run by British-owned Serco, and once they steal your patent, good luck finding any court to protect you. Until the U.S. Patent Office is run 100% by American interested and supported by law and order from the highest court in this land, especially the Supreme Court of the United States, which is currently looking at a writ of mandamus that we the people have sent to them right in their face. Get over it, Justice Roberts. It is time to look for truth. Because I am tired of inventors being ripped off, left penniless with hefty lawsuit fees, and permanently silenced in ever expressing their creations again. This has gone too far.
Absolutely. Over 5,000 patents have been seized this year alone. Last year, 5,700. So when you put a patent in, it goes to Serco. Serco is a British-owned company. Your patent leaves this country, goes to Serco, goes through a system they have to screen it to see if it has actually any effects upon supposedly national security. So for a national security issue here in America, we send it to the Brits through Serco for them to tell us, and then they seize that IP. They seize that intellectual property. So when Trump wrote an executive order recently saying he's going after these thieves, and particularly China, when you say China, you say Hillary Clinton. And when you say IP, you say Chinese theft, British theft, and Serco theft. Theft from America, the number one inventors in the world, America, and yet what happens? It gets absorbed by the national security issue, which goes directly to DARPA, InQtel, Highlands Forum, Leidos, SAIC, and all the other groups, and they steal the patent, weaponize it, and then give it over to international globalists to make money off of it. It's disgusting.
The U.S. Patent Office does not protect your property rights as inventors. They corner you like vultures. They are vultures. They're reptiles. And they steal your property and rights from you. And they do it like lawyers do it, all very legalistically, so that their corrupt courts can uphold their theft.
These lizards, as you call them, I'm going to explain exactly why that's true. But when you're a cold-hearted killer, a cold-blooded killer, a ruthless, stone-hearted killer, like the people who go out and kill inventors who turn in their patents, who then try to stand up to them and say, no, no, you can't steal my patent, and I'm going to continue to work on this. You are given a warning when they take your patent that you are not to speak to anyone ever again about your patent. You may not ever act upon it ever again. And if you ever start working on it again, you go to jail. Now, it's for like 10 years, and the fine can be anything that they want to fine you. Imagine that. You invent something for humanity, but because it can be weaponized, it's stolen from you, and then you are more than threatened, because if you go and you get in their face, we did a report once where we had to say, basically, give our respects to the hundreds of inventors who have been murdered by the U.S. Patent Office /Serco/the Brits/China/the Clintons.
And the dozens of inventors that contact us over the past year with real evidence of how their patents from the energy sector to the pharmaceutical and medical sectors were ripped off by the patent office and they were silenced. Just ask Justice John Roberts how he ruled in the Leader versus Facebook case. All the while holding Facebook stock, never recusing himself from this huge conflict of interest. So it's okay for a Supreme Court judge to grab his adopted children through illegal means, then rip off Leader Technologies, financially benefiting from Leader's invention, when its true inventor and courageous patriot, which we have all come to know on this channel, Michael McKibben, has never received anything. Thomas, he's received nothing for his invention. All the while, Dude Zuckerberg, Eric Schmidt, and Hillary Clinton run around this world using his trade secrets to enslave, surveil, and censor all of us.
And control our economy worldwide through the stock, the FANG stocks, which are all benefiting from Leader Technologies IP, which was stolen from them. Basically, trillions and trillions of dollars were stolen by the IBM Eclipse Foundation through James Chandler and the Clintons and the same cabal, Mueller, Comey, Rosenstein, Crocker, all of them. They were all down there in Little Rock, Arkansas at the Rose Law Firm when they said, look, technology is going to take over the world. We have to take over technology. And they did. And then they invented fake cardboard cutout people like Richard C. Walker or Jerry C. Jones. These are nothing more than Hillary stooges. And so when we're talking about the digital queen of the world, the monarch of the digital world, we're talking about Hillary Clinton, who now is moving a lot of her assets to China because she believes she can get better control over people in China than she can in America.
Keep in mind that globalists, Thomas, are like lizards. Energetically, they're just reptile beings with a lack of imagination and creativity. You mentioned James P. Chandler III. He was just a clever attorney among a swamp of clever lizard beings who stole patents and continued to do that from hardworking American entrepreneurs. Chandler never invented or created anything himself. All he does is teach other lizard attorneys how to steal from inventors. And then you talk about Hillary Clinton. Who was under Chandler's tutelage? Hillary Clinton. Her work at the Rose Law Firm early on was dedicated to intellectual property and patent infringement law. Now, she hid behind this. She was protecting children. That was not her intention at all. Her intention was to go in and grab the most important patents in America, steal them, and use them for her greedy, pathetic, lustful, sinful self.
That's a fact. And when you say lizard, there's three parts of the brain. There's the hind brain, the reptilian brain, the midbrain, the mammalian brain, and the forebrain, the human brain. These people are only in their reptile brain. They're only concerned about their own self-aggrandizement, their own hedonism, their own fulfillment of their desires. And they do not even rise up to the level of being a mammal, a warm-blooded mammal.
They're subhumans, these people, these globalists. They're subhuman, Thomas. They want to wipe away the culture, the uniqueness of each individual and turn us all into a gray slug body.
There's hardly a justice anywhere in the federal system and certainly practically any court where there isn't corruption. But when you go to the top, they're all insider traders. There's hardly a single top judge that makes decisions concerning the Clintons, Hillary Clinton's foundation, the top decisions being made in the Department of Justice. All of these things are so rigged and so slanted so that the people who are the most guilty never get any justice. Why don't the Clintons go to jail? We all know they're the most guilty people in Washington, D.C.
Well, what is Hillary's relationship to Richard C. Walker? You know him. We've written a lot about him. He's the prolific patent creator from Agilent. He has a patent, Thomas, on the Internet of Things. And all the while, Hillary holds the encryption keys to the Internet. She owns the whole frickin' planet!
She has taxes on everything. She has, oh, I don't know how many foundations, over 24 foundations. And anywhere money flows, she goes and taxes that money flow. And then she gets her part, and 2% goes to whatever they name the foundation after, and 98% goes to her, Bill, and Chelsea.
Frankly, the citizens of this country are beyond upset that the three branches in Washington cannot clean up this mess. I keep hearing from people, oh, trust the plan, trust the plan. There's no plan, people. We're the plan, and you better start working it. We have posted volumes on indictable evidence, volumes, that show the corruption in the swamp. From Rat Rodenstein's wife, Lisa Barsoomian, I mean, who the heck is she, that she is the number one article that people read on our site, to Dianne Feinstein's foreign interference in the elections. And don't get me started with Robert Mueller's involvement with terrorizing, yes, terrorizing Americans on September 11th, 2001, along with George Bush and Dick Cheney and the whole bit, and the nasty corruption of Mitt Romney, who operates the rigged voting machines we see, along with his son Tag, and then, of course, they're all funded by globalist colleague George Soros.
And all those things were rolled up into Christopher Strunk's writ of mandamus that he built upon James Miller and Michael McKibben and the IFI and AIM. All of us worked together to do this, but then it was taken straight to the Supreme Court and stuck in Judge Roberts' face. Now, is he going to do anything about it? The president said, we are in a state of emergency, and anyone who messes with the elections needs to be convicted. indicted, convicted to the full extent of the law. He then said, any American that sees any meddling in our election, report it to us. So this is more than a report. This is a writ of mandamus, a national security action through the armed forces section of the Homeland Security, which then goes directly to Justice Roberts himself, and he has to look at it immediately. So when it was filed early on Friday morning, he now has the weekend. But on Monday, if he doesn't do something about it, then we're just going to keep building on that case.
We are not going to let it go, because let me tell you what we are tired of. And we are tired of rigged election machines. It's been going on for quite a while. It needs to stop. We need to go to paper ballots, period. We are tired of outright patent thefts. If we expect America to grow and be great again and keep America great, we have to protect our inventors and our entrepreneurs. And we need to start by making right with Michael McKibben and Leader Technologies, the other inventors that can also step up and be righted by these crimes from the government to against people. And then the nasty woman still walking around with her corrupt sycophants. What Hillary Clinton does is she continues to show us that our nation is without law and order, and we need to right this. And then, not only that, we have a corrupt court system that turns a blind eye against this lawlessness, and I will say that the seat of that is with Justice Roberts. Now, he has an opportunity to right this wrong and get on the right path, and we will be watching him. But in the meantime, we do have a plan of action for people. We want you to do something. Get out of your chair right now and do something about it. This is our country, people, and we are the only people here to save it.
Judge Roberts, you're a lying, stinking, fake justice piece of excuse for humanity that doesn't rise up to humanity. Why? Because you're in charge of appointing the FISA court judges. And you see the corruption going on now. You've done nothing. You're the judge who, after Robert Mueller, already fake convictions on Paul Manafort and also the plea deals done for lying to Robert Mueller. That was Judge Contreras who sat on that impaneled grand jury. Judge Contreras, a FISA court judge, who was one of the judges who would have known of the FISA court abuse that was part of that case that has never been examined, which should have been the number one and first thing examined. So Judge Roberts, you, sir, have only one chance. And that's to now stand up, exactly as Betsy has said, and begin to bring the rule of law to the Supreme Court. And stop having fake justice appointments like Judge Leon, who is who is a personal friend of John Podesta's, yet he's looking at the case of Fusion GPS and Christopher Steele here in America. Or Judge Chutkan, who was placed to make sure that Imran Awan would not be even looked at for indictment or prosecution for the largest espionage case we've ever seen in U.S. history. You appoint these judges, and sometimes you'll knock a judge out of the seat and appoint another judge in a case because it's not going the way you want. This is fake justice. This is worse than fake justice. This is treason, it's sedition, and it shows that at least one of the branches of our government is completely corrupt, because if we look into who you have stock with, so many of you have Facebook stock from the beginning, even before it became an IPO, which shows that you were corrupt from the beginning. You knew that this weaponized, stolen patent material from Leader Technology was going to make people rich. They told you they needed your help in the courts. You got in with the stock, and you became filthy rich with your offshore accounts hiding it for you. You are disgusting.
Well, they're all disgusting. And you know, the Department of Justice and Mr. Magoo sitting up there and his 500 DOJ SES attorneys, and then you've got the FBI who can't find crime. It's a freaking mess. So citizens, we have gained our grassroots movement, and we're not going to stop. We encourage you to click on this link, because in it you're going to find some amazing tools that you can use against this tyrannical government. And stop talking about the future of the tyrannical government. It is here right now. The Americans for Innovation have a crime line. It'll take you a few minutes for it to download in your computer. That'll blow you away. And if you're a foreign actor, you've probably been harmed by these people in Washington. So you need to look in there and grab the evidence you can and start taking them to their very courts and calling out the corruption. And then, of course, Thomas, you and I, we've worked 2 years to put together the most amazing citizen intelligence reports that you can find on our website that really educate yourself on what really is going on in our world. And this is so important for all of us to do. You need to read this writ of mandamus, which is also attached here, to see what Christopher Strunk has called out. And they cannot hide this anymore, because in this writ, Thomas, we have listed in there the crime line from AFI, the citizen intelligence reports from the American intelligence media, so many other goodies that show that citizens are awake and we're sick and tired of it. So if you can't get your act together, you three branches of government, we the people are doing it, and we're doing it with this writ. So Justice Roberts, you better pay attention, you better read it, and you better know that the people out here in America are sick and tired of the swamp.
And you need to follow the law. And the law is you can't have a chain of custody through a digital machine. You have to have paper, and that there are 5 states that don't have paper backup, so that there can never be a full recount. There can never be a true election. The election responsibility is upon we the people. It is not upon the Supreme Court or the executive or the Congress. No, it is upon us. And so if we do not see the results that we need to see, which is honest elections, which we did not see in 2016, thank heavens for the MAGA tsunami in 2016, or we wouldn't even be speaking now. There'd be no free speech.
No, Dragonfly would already have been implemented in the United States.
Yes, and everyone who listened to one of these broadcasts would simply lose so much credit they'd start to take money out of your bank, just as they do in China. As a matter of fact, once they arrest you for using WhatsApp, which is nothing more than going onto Facebook, they take everything. You get snuffed out. You don't even go to jail. You don't even get to represent yourself. You get such a low social credit that you go to what they call free vocational training, which is re-education, where 3/4 of the people who go in do not come out alive. We've already seen this in China with the Uyghur people in the northwest part of China. That's what Dragonfly is. That's what Eric Schmidt is doing here in America. This is the last chance. We're going to say that free speech needs to be fought for, because the revolution will be over if we do not win this midterm election. And if we do not stop patent theft, then all of our enemies, which is everyone who is sucking off of America like a vampire, which would be China, Russia, Britain, but especially Britain. Remember the invasion coming out of Mexico? That's nothing compared to what Betsy's talking about here, which is the global alien invasion of America. It was a slow invasion from the time of the Declaration of Independence of Britain getting into Serco, getting into the Crown agents, getting into OPEC, getting their money, wherever money was flowing. That's where Hillary Clinton learned it. Wherever money was flowing in America, the Brits taxed us, and they're still taxing us to this day. It's just that they use companies that have American names that are on American soil, but all the money's being taken out of America. So the invasion of the globalists, these are aliens. These are not Americans. George Soros is not an American. Please, think about it, folks. Look at Oleg Deripaska. Look at the people spending tens of millions, and with Soros, look at it. A billion or two every single election he spends. This time he gave $18 billion to non-governmental organizations to fight Trump so that this midterm would go against Trump, so that they would try to impeach him, and so that in 2020 Trump would not win. Sorry, Soros, you're going to lose. Because why?
Because we're going to outlast him. And I'll tell you this. I mean, we watched this George Papadopoulos thing. We've been watching it for a long time, probably aware of what was really going on before George was. And you have the FBI actually setting this sting up against our president. This is not acceptable. Johnny Boy, that would be you, Justice Roberts. This has happened on your watch. You're the Supreme Court Justice of the United States. You have allowed this corruption to go on way too long. This is your opportunity to get it right. Now, I understand